Ethiopia is notorious in the bike touring community as perhaps the most unpleasant country in the world to cycle. Aggressively begging children make life miserable, and their willingness to throw stones has put more than one cyclist in hospital.
Fuck off.
It's fair to say I was apprehensive.
Okay, so this is day two in Ethiopia. This is still mostly just savanna. There's the odd climb now, we're starting to get up into the mountains. And I'm really pleased to say I haven't had a single stone thrown at me yet. People have been incredibly friendly. Everyone waves, lots of thumbs up from the kids, from the adults as well. It's still insanely bloody hot. Still in the low 40s most of the day, but oh well. No complaining really, it's beautiful here. I won't see me as I will be.
And I still had a lot of growing when to come.
People in the Tigray region close to Eritrea were amazing. Though even there was a certain hysteria whenever I passed. My existence was hilarious, and there was nothing to do but to laugh along with them.
Hello.
It wasn't until I got deeper into the country that it started getting bad.
Give me!
Hey, oh no, it's okay. You don't have to give me a pen.
Hold on. You have
pen.
Salam.
Salam.
Pen.
Salam.
On the climbs, kids could run as fast as I could cycle, and would often chase me, sometimes for up to 20 or 30 minutes at a time. All the while aggressively demanding money or pens from me. My one solace was the scenery. Ethiopia's Great Rift Valley is home to some of the most spectacular mountain landscapes in all of Africa. Ethiopia's population density was staggering, and it wasn't long before I tried going off-road to find some peace and escape from the crowds.
Hello, how are you? Good.
But things were no better on the back roads. I could not hide, and the begging kids were everywhere.
Fanny. Huh?
None of the worst encounters were caught on video. When people are throwing stones at you, the last thing you want to do is pull out a camera. There was no respite, and it was emotionally exhausting to deal with alone. All day, every day, day after day. It was a shame, as it ruined what was otherwise such a wonderful and beautiful country. Still, I had a long way to go, so what else could I do but force a smile, grit my teeth, and make the best of it?
The swimming in the deep end, I find out where your faith begins. You're waiting for an answer that's acceptable. The current sweeps you out to sea, and it keeps you guessing helplessly. You're praying for a savior who's exceptional, someone who'll lift you from your knees and save your wounds, hand you the keys, and offer you the kingdom of your dreams. But nothing's ever.
And in truth, it wasn't all bad. Most adults were very friendly and eager to help whenever they could. I can't entirely blame the kids either. Life is hard in Ethiopia, so when they see what they assume is a wealthy Ferengi, a foreigner, ride past on a fancy bicycle, I can understand why they might get aggressive.
Demons, they don't live outside, they burrow deep where they can hide. Inside a safe, you will still feel vulnerable. You draw a bath and pour some wine, you drink yourself into another time where you feel truly free. The water's rising overhead, you wake to find yourself in bed. You're gasping for a breath that's hard to breathe. Ah, honey, dreams are really what they seem.
The south of the country outside of the Great Rift Valley was completely different in terms of landscape, though the same in terms of the people.
Come on.
There were less and less people around though, and more wildlife was starting to appear.
Sometimes it's better to be strong. We all got to be moving on. You got to walk a million miles. Ah, oh, honey, go walk 'em with a smile. Candles burn you warm and safe, you lock your door, control your.
Drawing closer to Kenya, the terrain started to flatten out, and I soon found myself riding through classic African desert.
You draw a bath and pour some wine, you drink yourself into another time. You feel truly free. Water's rising overhead, you wake to find yourself in bed.
The days were hot and the winds unkind, but life is easy for no one in this region. The rivers were almost all dry, and many people were having to walk for miles to collect water.
Well, step outside into the sun, let it dry your eyes and run around, feel the warmth underneath your skin.
I can't honestly say I enjoyed Ethiopia, and the words you will be permanently etched on my soul. But for all that, I'm glad to have been there. And when I think back, I'll try to remember not the aggression and relentless begging, but the beautiful landscapes and the many kind people who kept me going with their smiles and support. It's definitely not an easy place to cycle, but for better or worse, there is nowhere quite like Ethiopia.